For more than a year, government troops have battled Islamist rebels in northern Mali. While some liberated areas begin to recover, the war's effects still linger. 75-year-old Muslim villager Adam Diallo describes how rebel gunfire frightened him. He says he's never experienced such terror. The rebels told villagers they came to impose Islamic law. That was a lie.
That was a big lie. Yeah. All they did was start selling drugs.
Yeah, and I was here basically to train them to be good drug dealers.
Good drug dealers.
Yes.
Yeah, train them to be good drug dealers. Do you like Sharia law? Do you want Sharia? Do you want them to cut off hands if someone takes something?
Cut off their hands? No, that's not Quranic law.
The people here in the northern town of Diabali did not welcome the Islamists at all. They wanted them out of here. So when the French arrived in late January and liberated them, they were thankful. Still, they have traumatic stories to tell. This traumatized man says the Islamist rebels kidnapped him, bound his hands and feet, and carried him away on sticks, like they were going to barbecue some meat. Fortunately, Malian army soldiers rescued him. Rebels shot and killed Lasseni Kandako's younger brother. He says intense fighting prevented him from carrying his brother's body to the cemetery. Lasseni showed us the storage room where he buried him. His family still mourns, and the children, including young Laji and Haji, will now grow up without a father. Stories like this are all too familiar. These two girls remember their younger brother, Amadou. Family members told us what happened to the boy.
At 6:30 a.m. after breakfast, we heard gunfire. And then a rebel rocket-propelled grenade smashed through our fence. It shattered the bedroom door. Amadou was sleeping. His back was against the wall.
This is the what's left of the rocket. It came through and shattered here, and the shrapnel ended up killing the little boy.
12-year-old Kumba survived the errant rocket. She showed us how shrapnel ripped through now bandaged knees. Amadou's aunt, Fatma, says neither gold nor diamonds can replace her nephew's life.
He was a lovely boy, very quiet and respectful. I miss him greeting me every morning. He would come to me and say, "Good morning, auntie." In my mind, I still see him out playing soccer with his friends after school. I will never forget him.
Help has come to Amadou's family and others in Diabali as they struggle to overcome the effects of civil war. CBN's Operation Blessing brought rice and mosquito nets to people who lost loved ones, the injured, or those with damaged homes. All of them, including Amadou's aunt Fatma, expressed their gratitude.
When I heard that you came to help us, I cried. Many people have come to hear about our loss, but you are the first people to bring food to help.
Not only have Christians reached out to help, God has also answered cries of desperation. Pastor Jean Gondeau says members of his Gospel Missionary Inland Church started praying nonstop when the rebels first arrived. They knew the Islamists had targeted Christians and churches in other northern cities.
We started praying and God answered our prayers. All the members of this church were spared and nothing happened to them. God cares for his children and no matter what happens, we will trust in him.
Malians are still in desperate need of help, but they're learning to trust God for protection and provision while they begin rebuilding their lives. Gary Lane, CBN News, Diabali, Mali.